Look what I got. It is the Hyundai NACS 2 CCS1 adapter that we all have been waiting for. Mine finally came. I got the email, I want to say, the first week of June. Got no shipping email, which did come after I already received it, but it did take about 3 weeks from the time I confirmed my address till the time this was delivered in my mailbox. Now, you can see this thing is big. I've got big hands, and I can't even get my hands around the NACS portion of the adapter right here. These are covers that I 3D printed. I am going to be selling these on my store. I haven't determined a price yet, but there's one for the CCS side. And then when you unlatch the NACS side, there's also one for that side as well. So that'll keep dust out. That'll keep debris out. The reason I created these is because I haven't been able to determine a good caddy to make for this to hold it in the car. Here in the Ioniq 6 and even in the Ioniq 5, this will not fit in the glove box unless you lay it down flat. So unlike the adapter I sell for 2025 Ioniq 5s that just allows it to sit in the glove box like this, it just doesn't fit, unfortunately. On the Ioniq 5, I'm gonna say the best place to leave this is going to be in the front trunk because it has the rubber liner. This isn't gonna slide around, and conversely, you can also keep it in the center console of the Ioniq 5 or in the lower portion of the center console here in the Ioniq 6. But if you're interested in these caps, check out my store at ioniqguy.com. Now, just for comparison's sake, here is the A2Z adapter that I purchased several months ago because I didn't really wanna wait for this. And you can just see, size-wise, very different. Here, I'll take the dust cap off too, just to make it an even more fair comparison. You can see, it is gigantic. The A to Z adapter is actually fairly ergonomic. I can actually almost get my hand around the NACS portion of the adapter. And it does feel a bit more high quality. Nice clicky latch here. I checked the weights, they're really close. But this is just larger and it has more empty space in it. But one knock against the supplied adapter versus the A to Z, the arm up here, plastic. The latch on the A to Z is a cast, probably aluminum, I would imagine. So that's a little more high quality. If you don't qualify for the Hyundai adapter, the A to Z can be had on their website for usually around 150, 160 bucks. If it's on sale, I've seen it down to about 130. But if you use code IONICGUY at checkout, you will get 10% off. So if you're interested in getting this, I'll have a link in the description below. I've only used the A to Z adapter once, and that was at one of the new Apple Green chargers on the New Jersey Turnpike on a trip down to Pennsylvania. And oddly enough, the only station open was a NACS station because all they do is take a CCS connector and permanently affix a NACS adapter to it. So in order to use that charger, it was a CCS cable with connector going into a CCS to NACS adapter, and then from the NACS adapter into my NACS to CCS adapter back to the car. The whole thing was about this long, just really easy to kind of knock into it if you weren't being careful and might damage your charge port. I really hate that implementation, Apple Green, that really sucks. So hopefully they'll just change over those connectors to be NACS natively. Now, I do want to let you guys know about a couple accessories I am going to have for the NACS adapter. So you can see on the end of it right now, I've got some dust covers. The latch engages it so it's not going to fall off. And then there is one for the NACS side as well that does have a little detent in it that engages with the lock here, so that's not going to fall out either. So now you can keep dust out of it because you do want to kind of keep those electrical contacts clean if you are going to store this in your front trunk or under the trunk floor or something where sand and dirt and stuff might be. Beyond that, I am also selling a little caddy for it. So you can see this is perfectly sized to fit right in there. It doesn't move around or anything. The bottom will have double-sided tape. Basically, if you want to store it in the glove box of the Ioniq 5, you can double-side tape that in, and then you can easily grab this, pull it out, put it back in. It's not going to rattle around or anything. The Ioniq 6 glove box is really quite squat, so it's not the easiest to access from in the glove box, but you can get it out and it will stay in place. I'm not going to tell you guys how to use it. You can use it in the front trunk without the tape if that's how you want to roll, but it will stick to the rubber mat in the front trunk pretty well to begin with. Now, just to specify, both of these accessories are specifically designed for Hyundai's NACS to CCS adapter. So here's the A to Z adapter in the tray, and it just doesn't fit. The CCS side dust protector does fit, but because the A to Z adapter does not have a user accessible latch for the NACS side, if you do insert the NACS plug into this side, it will get stuck. I will be offering these as a set, and then I will also offer this separately or with these at a discounted price. So if these are something that you're interested in, you can check those out on my website at ioniqguide.com. But now that we have the adapter, we're gonna go to a Tesla supercharger in the Ioniq 6 here. We're gonna drain this down to 10% and charge back up to 80% and see how long it takes with the Hyundai official adapter. Now, with these pre-NACS Ioniq 5s and Ioniq 6s, the most you're gonna see from a Tesla supercharger is about 97, 98 kilowatts, but we're gonna go give it a test. I gotta charge this car up anyway, so might as well run a test while we do that. So stay tuned, I'll see you guys at the supercharger. So we are at the version 4 supercharger here in Saugus, Mass. Actually, I think it might be Peabody. But either way, we're gonna plug in. We're currently at 11%. I tried to get down to 10%. I've got the AC blasting right now. It's 94 degrees out. So we're trying to bring it down to 10% in the next few minutes while I get set up here. All right, so we'll get the charge port opened. Pull out the cover here. Let's take off the dust covers. And the instructions are to plug in the adapter first, let go of that little clip on the bottom, and then we will plug her in and we will try and activate once we get back in the car. All right, so here's our charger. We are on 1A. Hit charge here. Start charging. We are on 1A and start charging. I'm leaving the AC on because it is really hot out. Remove the handle from the dock and attach, blah, blah, blah. We already did that. Let's see, is it gonna start or do I have to unplug to get it going? Oh, nope, initiating charging. We're ramping up, we'll start the timer. We are now up to 95 kilowatts, 96 kilowatts. So there you can see we are basically maxed out. So we'll see how long it's gonna hold 96 kilowatts. It says 37 minutes to 80%, but we've got that screen recording with the timer, so we'll see how accurate that is. So we're a little more than halfway through, and you can see still holding 96 kilowatts. The Tesla app is matching that. Interestingly, there is a discrepancy between what the Tesla app says is the charging time versus when I actually started the timer. So it's kind of like starting your charging time when it's like initiating versus when the contactors go and the car actually starts charging. So this top number is definitely going to be more accurate. The cooling system in the car was just going wild. I turned down the air conditioner in the car to allow it to do its thing. This way, this isn't a botched charging test. I really don't want to have to deal with that. But yeah, again, it is super hot out, 94 degrees right now. So it does need to do some work to keep the battery cool, even if it is only charging at 96 kilowatts. The rear motor is still doing a lot of work to boost the 400 volts coming out of the Tesla supercharger to the 800 volts necessary to charge the Ioniq 6 here. But yeah, this is looking pretty good. It looks like it's gonna be about 36, 37 minutes, 10 to 80%. So we'll check back when the test officially ends. All right, guys, we are 1 minute away from 80%. So I got the camera rolling. Here's the app. What's our time look like? Just under 35 minutes right now. So we might be under 36 minutes. It is held 96 kilowatts the entire charging session. So it's not really a curve, it's just a line. I'm going to bring this up to 90% just to see what it does after it hits 80%, if that does drop. There's 80, so we'll pause the time there. 35 minutes, 19 seconds. That's pretty good. Obviously, when the 2026 Ioniq 6 comes out, that'll be even better because it will hold 125, 130 kilowatts for a good portion of that charging session. Should be closer to about 29, 30 minutes. But yeah, that's good. So what we're going to do is let this go for a couple more minutes, see if the rate starts to drop a bit. And then I'm going to use a feature on my Google Pixel 9 that allows me to check the temperature of things. So I'm going to check the temperature of the charging adapter when we unplug it to see just how hot that thing got, considering it's still 94 degrees out, it's sitting in the sun, and it's got a lot of current running through it. So I'll be back in a minute once the... Okay, we just got the Korean Siesta. Drop down to 10 kilowatts. It'll probably hold that for a couple minutes and then go back up to a slightly higher level, but we will find out. All right, so it's been a couple minutes and we're ramping back up. Let's see what it goes up to. There's 64, 73, 90. Wow, 96. Maybe it will hold 96 up to almost 90%. That would be pretty impressive. Okay. We just dropped down to 74, 72, 71, 70. So about to 83%, you can pull full power at a Tesla supercharger. Nice. So about 120 degrees. Get my dust covers back on this and we will call it a test. See you back at the house. So to reiterate again, I'm pretty impressed with 35 minutes. Now me personally, I'm not going to go out of my way to use a Tesla supercharger when I can go to basically any other high power charger and get 235, 245 kilowatts with my Ioniq 6. That is unless this supercharger maybe is at a restaurant that I want to spend a little bit more time at and not have to worry about rushing to get back outside to move my car so idle fees don't kick in if you're at a station that does have those. Or perhaps you want to save a few dollars versus an Electrify America station or something. This Tesla supercharger is 55 cents per kilowatt hour, and just down the road at the Electrify America is 64 cents per kilowatt hour. So that's a difference of almost $6. So maybe for you, 15 minutes is worth an extra $6. All in all, I am impressed with this adapter. Besides it being gigantic, it is easy to use. Unlike the A to Z adapter, this has a manual latch on the bottom, which I do like because the A to Z does not. And I did have some difficulty getting the NACS cord at that Apple Green charger disconnected from the adapter. Took me about 3-4 minutes of wailing on it. Honestly, I was afraid that I was just going to have to leave it there, attached to the adapter, attached to the connector. So I do like that this one actually does have a manual latch to operate. Just remember, you can't use this with other low voltage EVs like a Chevy Equinox, a Ford F-150 Lightning. This is only rated for 350 amps. This is not rated for 500 amps. You're not going to want to use it with a low voltage car because it's going to draw way more than 350 amps and it risks overheating this. That might be an interesting test to do to see if this has something in it that can tell the charger or the car that it can't be used with a high current vehicle. So until other automakers switch to high voltage, this is strictly for Hyundai, Kia, and Genesis EVs. So anyway, guys, if you like today's video, give it a thumbs up. Check out my store at ioniqguy.com for accessories for your Hyundai, Kia, or Genesis EV. And as always, I will see you guys in the next one. Take care, everybody.